Good day, viewers. You are welcome to another educative section with Delwit Electrical, your reliable electrical partner. Today's video, we shall be teaching you or we shall be talking and discussing on the dangers of not putting off your electrical appliances and sockets when there is a power outage. Usually, I will take cognizance from Nigeria. My examples will be in Nigeria for those of my viewers outside the country who hardly experience power failure. Well, in Nigeria, and most citizens in Nigeria, you would notice that power outage is usually the order of the day, intermittent power outage. So we shall be discussing in the regions where people experience power outage. Now, when there is power outage, what usually comes to one's mind is the disappointment, and you forget that you have to put off your appliances. You will be discouraged and you feel that, oh, I'm supposed to be doing this and there is no power, and you might drive out of the house or leave your appliances on while living. So this is very, very risky, because whenever power is restored back, there's usually this high surge, because a lot of appliances are usually turned on, or most of them must have put it off. So this high surge of voltage is expected. So if your appliances are not put off, it might result to an electrical fire outbreak. So what are the steps, or what do you require to do whenever there's a power outage? First and foremost, I would advise that the moment there's a power outage, the first thing you have to do is to put off your electrical appliances and the circuits. Secondly, most people will also say that I have stabilizers, I have surge protectors, and because of this, I don't even need to care. Well, obviously, you don't need to care, because those appliances have the tendency to absorb high voltages. And also, when there are low voltages, there's every reason for your equipment not to get damaged. But we should all take cognizance of the fact that our country's border is becoming very porous. So the influx of already made appliances, such as your stabilizers and such protectors, are usually below standard. Our Standard Organization of Nigeria and most regulatory agencies have not taken that into consideration by ensuring that quality is being brought into the country. So the surge protector that you think will be able to protect your equipment now might not be up to the standard. What you're expecting is 220 volts. And when you get like 250 or 260 that is supposed to be absorbed by your surge protector, it will not absorb it, because the surge equipment that you think was supposed to do that is not. When you're using stabilizers for your building, and that is the only equipment you should leave on while you're living, make sure that your circuit breaker that is connected to that particular stabilizer is of high quality. You could determine that yourself. Now, another thing that is very responsible for not putting off your sockets when you are leaving your building is your heating system. Now, most heating systems are not treated. The moment you have packed into your building, you continue to use your heating forever, which is not supposed to be so. Heating is a very technical detail, and it requires technicality to ensure that your equipment are safe. I'll give you an example. If you have two entrances to a building, one of the entrances has a bouncer with broad chest, big muscles, and the second one has a very slim person. Most people definitely would require to gain entrance towards the entrance that has a slim person than going through the bouncer, because you believe you could beat the slim person and gain entrance. So also with electricity, whenever there's a fault current, for example, for your 13 amp socket, definitely when there's a fault, you'll be getting current close to like 20-something, 30-something amp. So what happens in that situation is that the current will look for the least path to follow. So when your earthing does not have the lower resistance, it will pass through your equipment that have lower resistance and get damage to your equipment. So that is why your earthing is very important. Earthing is technical, and we are going to be creating a video subsequently to talk entirely on earthing system to ensure that your building doesn't get damaged. Then thirdly, for your equipment, one of the major dangers that happens is most equipment is electronics are very expensive, and you require that if you don't take care of your equipment, and you don't take all these safety measures into cognizance, you get your equipment damaged. So for this lecture today, there are 5 basic points that you should take home from this video to ensure that you are safe. First and foremost, whenever there's power outage, what should come to your mind first is to ensure that all your socket points are switched off. Most people have automatic power changeover. For those that use solar, those that use generator, in that case, you don't have this problem, because for you to have automatic changeover system, your protection system should be very, very perfect. So whenever you are changing, all protection should be taken care of. you should do that. But if you don't have automatic changeover, it's advised that you put off electrical equipment before leaving the house. Secondly, our second take-home point should be that whenever power is restored, especially in Nigeria, our frequency fluctuation is very, very high. Most all equipments are supposed to be using 50 Hz, but you discover that because of the frequency fluctuation, sometimes you have 49, sometimes you have 51, 52, which is not advisable. So I usually encourage, whenever there is a power failure, which all your equipments are put off, give yourself like 2-3 minutes before you put up your equipment, so that the power must have stabilized before getting access to your equipment. Thirdly, what we have agreed on today is, if you are using heavy-duty equipment, like a washing machines, a ring boiler, or all equipment that require surge protection or stabilizers, I would also encourage us that don't think because you are using this equipment, you should not take protection. All these equipments are standard organizations of Nigeria, SON, has not done us well with our border. So there are so many fake equipment within the country. So these surge are supposed to regulate inrush current and fault current. But because we are not sure of what we are actually buying, you might not be able to take cognizance of that. So please ensure that that is taken care of. Then your circuit breakers and your distribution board. Now, most of you might not know what your distribution board is, but every building has a distribution board, which is where all your points, electrical points, are connected to. I would encourage you that from time to time, please try and see that your distribution board is of standard. If you don't know, contact a qualified electrician or electrical engineer to come and check. So please, if you are in a rented apartment that is not, or your personal building, and you're not sure of the electrician that carried out the process for you, please call a qualified electrical engineer or a qualified electrician to come and take cognizance of that distribution board. Distribution board is not difficult to see. Every building has it. It's a box within an environment where all your electrical appliances are connected to. Please check it. Then the final one is your earthing system. Please ensure that you carry out your earth test at least once a year. It's very important. Most people, since they build their houses, they've never carried out the earthing system, the earth test. So it's the earth resistance test that was done since the building was done. That's what they're still using today. So I encourage building commercial or residential apartments at least once a year, carry out an earth test to ensure that your resistance of 2 ohms or below is being achieved. Then for fire outbreaks in buildings, what is usually advised for residential building, at least your 2 kg fire extinguisher should be close to your distribution board, so that in case of any fire outbreak, before you call for help, you could just take your fire extinguisher and extinguish the fire before it turns to an inferno. So I believe I've been able to educate you today on the dangers of not putting off your sockets and electrical appliances whenever there's a power outage. Feel free to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification icon to get notified whenever subsequent videos will be posted. Thank you very much for being our channel, and do hope to get more videos from you.